read one of your submissions, I look for one thing. I look for what I can tell you that will help you improve that document, that'll help you make it better, more readable, and thus get you a better grade. So I'm going to send comments back to you, and that's what those comments are aimed at. Whether you decide to revise the document or not is entirely up to you, but my comments will be based on revision, what I see in the document that will make it better. If you receive the document back as an attachment, you'll see several different things. I'll either use the comment function in Microsoft in order to actually tell you things about the document, tell you what I like, tell you where there's a problem, and try to explain in detail, if necessary, how to solve that problem. If they're basically style and grammar problems, I expect you to be able to start to learn how to take care of those yourself. So for those, what I'll do is I will highlight the passages that are causing problems in yellow. Now, what are you supposed to do with that? You're supposed to take a look at it and see if you recognize a problem. That's the first step. If I tell you what the problem is every time, you're not going to solve it on your own. Now, if you read it, you see what the problem is, you correct it. If you read it and you don't see what the problem is, the next step is, simply enough, read it out loud. Often when we're reading a passage out loud, we notice things in the passage that we didn't notice when we were reading it just in our head. In addition, as we're reading out loud, there's a flow to the language, and we will read with that flow. And particularly if the problems with that passage are problems in punctuation, we will tend to pause where there's a comma, pause even longer where there's a period, and that will show us where to correct those mistakes. Now, if you're still having a problem with those yellow highlighted passages, then you either need to call me, text me, email me, come by the office and see me, and we'll go over them together. You can also chat with me online in Blackboard. In addition, you can go and see a tutor in the Writing Center. One of the things they're very good at is helping people with grammar and style problems. The third type of marking you're going to see in your paper will be simply having words, even passages, blacked out. And what I'm doing there is I'm trying to point out to you that you're being a little too wordy. For some reason, all of us tend to write more than we really need to communicate. If we get more words on the page than actually communicate, those extra words actually get in the way. So when I block out those words, what I'm asking you to do is to read that sentence now without those words and see if it's as clear or clearer than it was with the words. And I think the reason we add those extra words is when we're trained to do that in high school, middle school, and even elementary school, when we had an assignment that had to be 200 words long or had to be 5 pages long. And we added extra words to fill in those pages. We want to do just the opposite in tech writing. We want only the words that are going to communicate our message. So take those three types of feedback, look at your paper, revise it if you want to, set it aside if you're happy with it, and go on to the next one, and take that as a learning experience. Okay, I look forward to seeing more of your submissions.